wait in Jerusalem for the receiving, the coming of the Holy Spirit. And then after they received the Holy Spirit, they were sent out to be witnesses of Jesus Christ, to be witnesses of Jesus' resurrection, beginning in Jerusalem, Samaria, and all to all the ends of the world. We are called to be witnesses of Jesus, and we have received the gift of the Holy Spirit. We receive it through the sacraments, especially through the sacrament of confirmation. In a special way, we are sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Throughout this Easter season, we've been reading from the book of the Acts of the Apostles, the first reading, and the second reading from the letter, the first letter to Peter, is what we've been reading throughout this Easter season. So today, as we prepare ourselves to celebrate this Holy Eucharist, let us examine our conscience and ask the Lord for pardon for our sins. In silence, let us do an examination of our conscience. And now let us say all together, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you.
God Almighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth Let us pray. O God, whose Son today ascended to the heavens, as the apostles look on, grant, we pray, that in accordance with his promise, we may be worthy for him to live with us always on earth, and we with him in heaven, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now be seated and listen to the word of God. We remove the missalet from the pews for the coronavirus that, you know, but let us listen to the readings.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up. After giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen, he presented himself alive to them. By many proofs, after he had suffered, appearing to them during the 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom of Israel? He answered them, It is not for you to know the times or the seasons that the Father has established by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking for the sky? This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will return into the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy. Clap your hands, shout to God with cries of gladness. For the Lord, the Most High, the Awesome, is the great King over all the earth. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. God mounts his throne amid shouts of joy, the Lord amid trumpet blast. Sing praise to God, sing praise to our King, sing praise. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord. For King of all the earth is God, sing hymns of praise. God reigns over the nations, God sits upon his holy throne. God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation, resulting in knowledge of Him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to His call, what are the riches of glory in His inheritance among the holy ones, and what is the surpassing greatness of His power for us who believe, in accord with the exercise of His great might, which He worked in Christ, raising Him from the dead and seating Him in His right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, in every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And He put all things beneath His feet and gave Him as head over all things to the church, which is His body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in heaven, all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they saw Him, they worshipped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Lord, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always until the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today we celebrate the Ascension of the Lord into heaven. In the first reading today from the book of the Acts of the Apostles, Jesus tells His apostles that He will receive, that they, the apostles, will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon them, and then He ascends into heaven. In the second reading today, in his letter to the Ephesians, St. Paul affirms the hope and joy by all who believe in the promise and power of Christ. And St. Paul talks about the wisdom and knowledge that comes from the Holy Spirit. When you think about the gifts of the Holy Spirit, wisdom, understanding might be the first gifts that you may recall. Wisdom, knowledge of the Holy Spirit, understanding. Because remember the day of Pentecost when the apostles were gathered to pray, gathered in prayer, as they received the gift of the Holy Spirit, they rejoiced, they felt joy, and they were able to understand each other. And they had no fear. They went out and proclaimed Jesus. They knew other languages. They understood each other. The gift of the Holy Spirit to forgive sins. St. Paul affirms the hope and joy by all who believe in the promise and power of Christ. In Matthew's Gospel, Jesus commissions the apostles to make disciples of all nations, go to the ends of the earth, and assures them that he will be with them always until the end of the age. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all the nations. On the day of the Ascension, the apostles gather to pray. They gather and they pray. And it's exactly what we are doing today. We are gathering and we are praying together. We read the Holy Scripture, and now we are about to celebrate the sacrifice of the Eucharist. Gather as a community of believers, gather as a community of baptized. Remember that the day of the Ascension, the apostles were gathered in that mountain where Jesus called them to be together after the resurrection, 40 days after the resurrection of the Lord, while looking intently at the sky during the ascension of Christ. The apostles were still unsure of what was ahead of them. They didn't know. They didn't have that outpouring of the Holy Spirit that will come in 10 more days. Jesus declares the apostles' mission and assures them that the Holy Spirit will guide and lead them as his witnesses to the ends of the earth, as his disciples. We share in this mission. We are emboldened by the knowledge that he is always with us and confident that he will come again. So today, we are getting closer to the end of the Easter season. So Easter begins with the resurrection of the Lord. Then 40 days after the resurrection, the ascension of Jesus into heaven. And he tells his apostles not to leave Jerusalem. Wait until you receive the Holy Spirit. 10 days later is when we celebrate the coming of the Holy Spirit, Pentecost, and the establishing of the church with Pentecost, coming the Holy Spirit, the church established. And then they go out. They go out, beginning in Jerusalem, Galilee, Samaria, and out to the ends of the world. So today we are called to be witnesses of Jesus Christ. How can I be a witness of Jesus when I encounter another person? How can I acknowledge the gifts of the Spirit, that wisdom, joy, courage, the gifts of the Holy Spirit be manifested in us? So today, as we celebrate the ascension of the Lord, let us be witnesses of Jesus and bring the word of Jesus to the ends of the earth.
Amen.
Please stand. Let us now proclaim our faith together, the creed. profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. On this joyous day, making Jesus Christ return to his Father in heaven, we offer our needs and the needs of those around us. Please respond to each petition. Lord, hear our prayers.
For the church, that we continue to carry on the commission Christ gave to his first disciples, preaching, teaching, and baptizing through all nations. And let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That all nations lay down their arms and resolve never again to use instruments of death to resolve disagreements and discords. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who suffer from systematic persecution, oppression, and discrimination, that justice and righteousness may overcome sin and evil. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who were welcomed into the church this Easter season, as they go forth to make disciples in the way that they live their faith-filled lives, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all of us, that we may be blessed with wisdom, hope, so that we may be effective witnesses in our communities of the joy and consolation of our faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the faithful who have gone before us, in a special way for Garobi Hoey, may they receive the rewards of eternal life in heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all our intentions spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. God in heaven, you raise up your Son, who now sits at your right hand in glory. Listen to the prayers we make here on earth and grant them through your Son, our Lord, risen and ascended. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The second collection is for the loan payment for land on Bauman Road. Children, please come forward and place the children offering in the basket in the center aisle. Thanks for your gift. Thanks for your offering.
Jesus Christ, by faith revealed in your gathered church at prayer. God with us as love we pray. Make your presence known today.
Lord, wash away my iniquities. Wash away my iniquities and cleanse me from my sins. Wash away my guilt and cleanse me from my sins. Sisters and brothers, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to Almighty God.
May the Lord accept.
O God, whose only begotten Son, our High Priest, is seated ever living at your right hand to intercede for us, grant that we may approach with confidence the throne of grace and there obtain your mercy through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the Lord Jesus, the King of Glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended to the highest heavens as the angels gaze in wonder, mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts. He ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ at the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Guerrero Hoy, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Charles Borromeo, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may marry to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Jesus taught us to call God our Father. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And now from a distance, let us offer each other the sign of Christ's peace. Peace of Christ be with you. Peace be with you. Peace of Christ.
On us, Lamb
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body of Christ bring us to life. Keep us safe for it. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. 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 Amen. The body of Christ.
Behold the death.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Living now.
The body of Christ.
Jesus the Christ.
The body of Christ. The body
once
of Christ.
We were people afraid. Lost in the light. And by your cross we were saved. Dead became living. Life from your giving. Behold the death of the Lord. Even
all.
Living now we remain.
The body of Christ.
Jesus the Christ.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Something which we have known.
The
something
body of Christ.
We turn.
The body of Christ.
What we have seen with
the
all
body of Christ.
Eyes. This we have heard.
The body of
life-giving
Christ.
Life-giving word. We owe the death of the Lord deep in our hearts. Living now we remain with Jesus the Christ. He chose to give of himself, became our bread, broken that we may live, love beyond love, pay for our pain. Death of the Lord deep in our hearts. Living now we remain with Jesus the Christ. We are the presence of God. This is our call. Now to become bread and wine. Food for the hungry, life for the weary. We hold the death of the Lord deep in our heart. Living, now we remain with Jesus the Christ.
Let us pray. May the gifts we have received from your altar, Lord, kindle our heart, kindle in our hearts a longing for the heavenly homeland, and cause us to press forward, following in the Savior's footsteps, to the place where for our sake he entered before us, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May Almighty God bless you, for in this very day his only begotten Son pierced the heights of heaven and unlocked for you the way to ascend to where he is. Amen. May he grant that as Christ, after his resurrection, was seen plainly by his disciples, so when he comes as judge, he may show himself merciful to you for all eternity. Amen. And may you who believe he is seated with the Father in his majesty know with joy the fulfillment of his promise to stay with you until the end of time. Amen. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, come down upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. The Mass has ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For the exit, we have changed now. We want everybody to exit through this side, through this door, and the bulletins. Make sure you give out the bulletins so that when everybody's gone, they may clean up the pews. That's the new way to, since the coronavirus. Thank you.
Sent forth by God's blessing, our true faith confessing, the people of God from this dwelling take leave. God's sacrifice ended, oh now be extended, the fruit of his mass in all hearts do believe. The seed of Christ teaching all inner souls reaching, God blossom in action for God and
this
for
way. Clemente, Clemente.
God's grace shall incite us, love shall unite.